Namaste! Welcome to Bhavna's Kitchen. Today I'm going to show you how to make Badam Mysore Pak. Almond fudge. So let's begin.
ये मैंने ले लिए है सारे ingredients. I'm taking 1 cup badam powder, almond meal. 1 cup, 1/2 cup sugar, 1 cup ghee, clarified butter, 1/2 cup cream or fat milk, and elaichi to flavor it up, cardamom, ground cardamom. यहाँ पे मैंने tray ready कर ली है. I'm using perforated tray to drain excess ghee, and at the bottom I'm taking big plate.
So far I have tried out making Mysore Pak 2 ways. Some people just mix everything and cook till ghee separates from the mixture, and then pour into the tray and let extra ghee drain. The other method, it's the traditional method where sugar syrup is prepared and then the gram flour basin or any ingredients that you are using, almond flour, badam powder basically, and coconut, desiccated coconut or whatever you are using to prepare the Mysore Pak is added. And then once you cook for about 5-10 minutes again after adding the badam or the basin or the coconut, you start pouring the warm ghee that is heat up in another pot. So that's the second method. Actually, that's the first method, and the second method people adopted just for to make it easier to prepare Mysore Pak. Either way you make it, just make a just a slightly little difference. Maybe with the first traditional method you get more pores, like, or more airy Mysore Pak, while with the second one you get little tiny holes, or sometimes you may see very little holes in your Mysore Pak, but it will still give the nice taste. The taste remains the same for both recipes. So it's truly up to you how you want to prepare this Mysore Pak. In this method, I'm going to mix everything into the pot and cook. So ghee, clarified butter, cream or fat milk, almond meal, badam powder. Turn on the stove on a medium to high heat, and sugar. So everything into the pot and start cooking. Give it a good stir first. Break all the lumps of badam and keep cooking till ghee separates, and you will see the color change in the mixture. Any method you use, one or two, it takes anywhere between 20 minutes to 25 minutes to get Mysore Pak done. But always use your judgment, and just be sure to pay attention to the signs of doneness. Mixture started bubbling after about 7 minutes. These bubbles are the key to prepare perfect Mysore Pak, airy with lots of pores. You will feel that the mixture starts getting lighter and fluffier. But again, continue cooking till ghee separates and you will see the color change. It's close to 14 minutes. I brought down the temperature low to medium. As you can see, it is changing the color. Ghee is separating, and the mixture has been cooking for about 16 minutes now, and as you can see, oozing out ghee and changing color quickly. So sometimes if your pot is wide, you may not have to cook 20 minutes, so just use your judgment. As I said, I want just a slightly little bit more brown. As you can see, ghee is coming out of it, and it is now brown as well. Turn off the stove.
and quickly bring down the mixture into the perforated tray. Do not try to press too much. Just shape it if you want to, because I want some high pieces. I am just going to get it on one side so I can get big pieces. While it is still nice and warm, sprinkle cardamom, elaichi, ground elaichi. Now it smells amazing. And since it is badam mesu pak, here I have some almonds which I'm just going to poke in while the mixture is still nice and hot. Perfect. Now before it gets hard, cut into pieces, big, small, however you want, and be sure not to touch your knife to the plate. In some places it gets hard quickly, in the middle it takes a little bit of a time. All right, and let it cool completely. Now I took out the tray into another plate. As you can see, a lot of ghee separates at the bottom. When it cools down, you can remove the pieces carefully. And look at this miso pak. And look at this badam miso pak.
So here I have my badam miso pak ready. Looks so yummy. And the remaining ghee you can use in your roti or paratha if you like them sweet, or else just using something that you can think of that you usually prepare. And I am actually ready to eat this miso pak. So yummy. I hope you enjoyed making miso pak with me. Please do like and comment below, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel for new recipes every week. And also please do visit my website boundlesskitchen.com for more recipes, tips, tricks and ideas in the kitchen. Thank you for watching and see you soon.